We left the EU, as everyone knows, on the 31st of January. The Prime Minister got Brexit done. We're now in a different stage. We're talking about a free trade agreement with the EU. One of the things, however, though, is that as those talks have gone on, there are things that the EU should have been doing, which it committed to do, in order to make sure that we could have the free flow of food into the EU, subject to certain checks, in due course. The EU haven't been keeping their side of the bargain on that question, and that raises doubts and concerns more broadly. Now, we want a deal. We hope that we will get a free trade agreement between the UK and the EU. I think it's in everyone's interests. But we've got to make sure that we have an insurance policy if the EU aren't as cooperative, as we hope they will. The legal position was made clear by the Attorney General. We're operating within the rule of law. It is the case, however, that we do need to take insurance policies. We hope that we don't need to implement the provisions that exist within the UK Internal Market Bill. But why are we bringing this bill forward? Because it is part of implementing the withdrawal agreement and the Northern Ireland Protocol. It's part of making sure that we can continue to have unfettered access for goods from Northern Ireland, from businesses in Northern Ireland, so they can continue to benefit from being part of the United Kingdom. I think that one of the arguments is by your actions, some people have said, oh, you're making it more difficult to secure agreements with other countries. Well, we've just secured an agreement with Japan. Some people say, oh, well, outside the EU, you won't be able to get better terms for the UK. We just have. And some people say, oh, there's no link between the two. Well, I think, actually, Britain concluding free trade agreements with other countries shows that we should be able to secure a free trade agreement with the EU.